Breaking news, my lovely, wonderful people. Not be smart in Asari Dokubo don't talk. He said this now why he threatened the governor of River State. Asari Dokubo open up. Guess what? Nothing is being done to him. Oh yeah, he goes free. Nobody can touch him, talk to him. He can show video of him, you know, training soldiers and doing whatever. And nobody can talk because he has the man on his side, speaking about Asiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu. Asari Dokubo has gone on now to say, you know what, he threatened the governor, a sitting governor, and guess what, nobody has said a single word up until now. Not even the DSS has called Asari Dokubo for questioning. Welcome to Nigeria. In case you are wondering, yes, such lawlessness take place and no question is being asked, where there are two laws, okay? There are laws for some and there are laws for the others. You get it, for some and for others. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, like us, share, subscribe. Let's get all the details. Why I threatened the River State governor, and he's not denying it, so yet no answer, nobody talks to him. Yes, The former militant leader, is he a former or still a militant leader? Asari Dokubo has opened up on the reason why he threatened the River State governor for Baro. Late Nigeria report that Dokubo, in a viral video, stated that the governor for Baro will face more serious issue than Boko if he did not stay clear of his business. If the governor keep intruding into my business, he will see more rat than Boko Haram are doing in the north. The US militant leader also claimed that the governorship election that brought Fubaro into power was rigged. Speaking during a Facebook live over the weekend, Dokubo alleged that Fubaro asked security operative to attack and possibly kill him, the reason for his open threat to the governor. He added that he has the right to live and nobody can take his life because he has not committed any crime. He said after the crisis of 2003-2004, nobody has heard my name in any crisis. I have my right to live, naturally guaranteed and given by God, and nobody has the right to take it. Fubaro is mending into my business. What business is he mending into? Oil rigging. In case you are not aware, you are wondering which business? Oil rigging. And if you know River State, too, it's one of the oil producing states. And you know where Asari Dokubo came from and his boys and all that they are doing. Let's continue. Nobody has the right to ask anyone to attack me or kill me. I've committed no crime. I have worked for my government and I should be rewarded. I am doing my legal job and business. It is not the governor's business to be mending into my affairs and understanding what I'm doing. I did not call him. The governor does not send security after me. If he does it, what he will be facing will be worse than Boko's, and I'm not joking. I don't even know who I am fighting. They know me, so I should be walking around without security. Where do I display weapon? How many times do people see me in the public? So why should I be disturbed? Let everyone mind their business. This is what the people are trying to do, to challenge everyone and anyone who has power. They can't do that to me. I will not allow it. That's Asari Dokubo. And in case you are wondering, he's threatening a sitting governor and nothing has been done to him. He's not been called to questioning, even up till now as we speak. He first of all made a video threatening the governor. It's not hearsay. So you now say, oh, it's because people are just saying he threatened the governor. No, he made a video threatening the governor. I want to compare. Yeah, you will permit me, please. I crave your indulgence. What did Nnamdi Kanu do that made Nigerian government to tag him in quote and unquote terrorists? They said he was threatening Nigerians' unity. He was doing this. He said, if we're not going to be included, let us go. What is Asari Dokubo doing now? Tinubu right-hand guy. What is he doing? He's threatening a sitting governor. Now in the constitution, is that right? It's not just threatening him. That's when I say, I think he's threatening, or I heard him threatening. That's hearsay. He's telling you to your face, do your worst. He made a video telling the world that the governor is disturbing his business and the governor does not take his time. Yeah, he will deal with him
like he has been, like what has been happening, you know, in the northern part of the country, that what the governor will get to be worse than that. That's a militant too. Or will I say formal militant? And guess what? The Nigerian DSS that is quick to invite people for questioning, their ears is blocked, their eyes is closed. They cannot see, they cannot hear. This is the same case as what we had the other time. Okay, Yashukundi. And up until today, it was even the police that was explaining to us what Yashukundi means. It was the Nigerian police that was explaining that he said Yashukundi is his customer and that they were having a laugh. So welcome to Nigeria. In case you are wondering, you are trying to think about it, that what is going on, welcome. I have to greet you because you have done well to try to understand what is happening. Have you heard of nonsense? This is the definition and beginning of nonsense. And it happens in tribes when like minds, okay, when they flock together. And guess what? Even the governor, he has to mend himself because there is no protection for him. Because this threat is coming from above. What he can do and get away with it, and no question, it means that it's being backed up. If it's not being backed up, he cannot carry on with such impunity and feel or think that he can go free. He's walking and going free because somebody somewhere is supporting him. Somebody somewhere has told him, don't worry, you are okay. If anybody threatens you, I threaten them. That's why he's doing what he's doing. That's why. So don't think that, you know, you don't think that things are just going like that. No, there is somebody somewhere who has made up his mind to say, you know what, whatever happened, we are in charge. So don't be afraid. You know, don't be afraid. That's why, you know, that's why it's behaving the way it's behaving. I can tell you for free. That's why. If not, there will be more decorum and people will be very careful of how they display themselves and how they comport themselves. These things are happening because somebody somewhere has told somebody that you're untouchable. Continue. Nothing will happen to you. So this is what we are experiencing today. My people, if you never see anything, it will be nonsense before. This is the clear-cut definition. I would like to hear from you to know what you think. Because, you know, evil happen and continue to happen when those that should speak are really not speaking and have made up their mind to say, you know what, we will not do anything about it. But it's, as soon as procedures are set in place and it's adhered to, you will see that the difference will become evident for all to see. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Like us, share, subscribe. God bless. Have a fantastic and a lovely day. From us, it's bye for now.